First, the breath of God. Only the penitent man will pass. Second, the word of God. Only in the footsteps of God will he proceed. Third, the path of God. Only in the leap from the lion's head will he prove his worth.
What does that mean?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Hey everyone, thanks for joining me again. Modern Collector here with another prop review. So just before I begin, I wanted to detail some of the props that you might see me review on this channel. Perhaps you've already seen the Factory Entertainment MIB Noisy Cricket prop I reviewed, and the Factory Entertainment James Bond rebreather set I reviewed earlier. In addition to those sort of more mass-produced limited edition props I collect, I also like to create some props of my own. I also took a look at the Apple II Plus, which is what the lost Swan Station hatch computer is based off of, one of my all-time favorite TV shows. And then I also collect what you see in front of you here. So these are very limited edition, custom-made props as well. This prop in particular is from Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. It is the Grail Diary that Indy receives from his father, Henry Jones Sr. I had the fortune of picking this up about a year or two ago from a gentleman by the name of Pasquale Marcella. He owns the website Movie Prop Studios, which is based in Italy, I believe. When I received this prop, it was packaged in a padded manila envelope, and I received it like you see before you. It is wrapped just like Indiana Jones received from his father. If we take a look at it, it does say, to Professor Indiana Jones, Barnett College, Hamilton Hall, Grove Avenue, Fairfield, New York. It does come with stamps and then also these markers here, which are Italian markers. I have since removed the Grail Diary from the packaging, but I did backfill it with some cardstock to give it some form and a little bit of heft. If you bear with me for one moment, I will take a look at the Grail Diary. Thank you. Here's the Grail Diary itself, unwrapped from its parchment paper wrapping. So before we take a look at the book itself, I thought I'd go through some of the details of this particular prop. So this is actually an exact replica of the Hero prop. The pages inside exactly mirror what you see on screen. The book is comprised of 282 pages, and it has all 20 inserts that you do find in the Hero prop as well. The cover itself is weathered and bound, just like the original book, and it is made of cowhide leather. I'm not sure if you can make out the weathering and detailing of this particular prop, but feels quite nice in the hand. The pages are actually stitched into the spine by hand, authentically replicating how it was made for the movie. And I'm not sure if you guys know this, but the text inside is actually based off of the book The Grail: Quest for the Eternal by John Matthews, and a lot of the text inside is copied directly out of that book. So if you guys are interested, I would suggest you take a look on Amazon or the like for that particular book. So let's take the elastic off and see what's inside. So right when you open the book here, you get a letter, and it reads, "Dear Junior, here's my Grail Diary. Please, under all circumstances, guard it with your life. I hope to be able to retrieve it from you soon. Your father, Henry Jones Sr., dated 3rd of January, 1938, Venice, Italy." So that's the first thing you see when you open the book. You do see that there are a lot of inserts replicated here. And I will go in depth and take a look at the key pages in this book in a moment, but I just wanted to do a quick flip through for you guys so you can see the quality of the illustrations and some of the inscriptions that the book contains. At the back of the book, we also see we have a, I'm not going to unwrap this, but we do have a rubbing of the shield. Put this back here. And then we also have, and you can see this at the end of the movie where Indy is taking a leap of faith here. This is faithfully replicated as well. And you see this painting on Henry Jones Sr.'s wall at the beginning of the movie. All right, so let's take a look at a closer look at some of the pages inside the book. Here is one of the pages that you can clearly see in one of the screenshots from the movie. And another faithfully replicated image from the book. I don't think these two particular pages are in the movie, but I just wanted to show you how detailed the book actually is. A page with insert that's helpful to Indiana Jones while he's in the Venice Library. X marks the spot. The Canyon of the Crescent Moon. And the Three Trials One Must Face. First, the Breath of God. Only the penitent man will pass. Second, the Word of God. Only in the footsteps of God will he proceed. And third, the Path of God. Only in the leap of faith from the lion head will he prove his worth. The cup of a carpenter. So all in all, this is an amazing prop set for a film that has had a tremendous influence on my childhood. As a film goer, and now as an adult, as a prop collector, I feel so privileged to be able to collect some of these things that have touched my life and the life of so many other people. Especially in this case, when I think of books that have appeared in movies, this is definitely the one that I would say has the most broad appeal for me and for a lot of my friends. And yeah, thank you for taking a look at my prop review. I'm not sure, and please let me know in the comments if you would like me to continue with these customized props rather than just reviewing more mass-produced props. If you'd like me to see more of these, I would definitely do more of them for you guys. Thanks for joining me again. Have a great day.